Hi everyone, this is Lisa from Canine Clips, and this is Bowie. And Bowie is a Cocker Spaniel mixed with a Bichon Frise. And he is coming for his full groom today. He is actually 13 years old, so he's one of my senior guys. And he's going to actually be getting a number 10 full shave down on all his body. So it'll kind of keep him cool. As you can tell, he's a little bit nervous. And he's quite warm. He's not used to all this fur on here. So I'm going to give him a nice clean shave up. But I will be shaving his head and face, the ears and tail. So I'm not going to be using the scissors on that today, unless he doesn't like it. So actually, I'm going to be starting on his feet at the moment and get him ready for the bath. And then I'll be cleaning out his ears. So I am going to trim around his ears. As you can see, they're a little bit full and dirty. So full of hair and a little bit of wax as well. And typical with the Cocker Spaniels and Bichons, they usually have a lot of hair in their ears. So it's very important to keep those clean, especially with the Cockers, because they have really heavy ears as well. And that can be a sign for an infection if they're not kept nice and clean. But the inside of his ears are actually not as heavy as some of the Cockers are. So then he has the Bichon characteristics in there. So that's good. But nice and heavy ears for sure. So I am going to pluck this hair out. Just to get that out of there. And of course it's going to be a little bit irritated because they are quite full. But I just got to work around him. So you can see how much wax is in there. So that's why it's a little bit irritating for him, for me to pull this out. But usually as I keep going, they get a little bit better and better, because it feels a little bit better and better. But of course, it's still annoying and feels probably weird for them. I mean, we're digging in there. Good boy. Get out of your way. Oh, you're doing so good. Okay. Good boy. Hey. There we go. So there's the last of that ear. So while I'm on the ears, I'm actually going to do the other one now, since he knows what I'm doing. So you can see this one is also quite irritated. Lots of hair, wax in there. You can see the wax is actually coming out on the edges there. Once I get this hair out, it'll help, because then the wax won't have the hair to stick to, so that when he does shake and scratch his ears there, it should hopefully come dislodged. You can see this hair is quite long in here. Might have gotten missed by the previous groomer. Sorry, I try to follow along with the camera as best I can. I'll try moving this down so that when he raises his head, he can still see. Okay. Ah. Okay. All right, there we go. So there's that ear in two sections. All right, now I'm going to start trimming up the feet and nails. His feet are quite full. So like I said, I'll try my best to get him on the video to give you the best view, but it all depends how we can work with each other here to get you the best view too. He is a little bit bigger of a dog, so I do have to have the camera a little bit further away. Okay, so there you can see how much fur is in there. So for him, because he has the bigger pads, I am going to try to use the clippers in there. See if he doesn't mind it. I don't mind using it on the dogs that have bigger feet. Yeah, but I find they still don't like it. So I will go back to the scissors. Dogs don't mind the clippers, so it is sometimes can be a little bit faster, but I find if there's mats in there and if you're digging, they don't really like that vibration sound. And if their feet are overgrown and nails are overgrown, their feet can become sore. Okay. And just that extra vibration probably doesn't feel good on them. So with all cockers, his fur is very thick. I'm just going to try to get it all out here. And clean it up best I can, but I will be coming with the number 10 clipper in here as well. So I just want to get it between the toes and stuff, because you can't really do the clipper between the toes. Got some really cool long claws here. And he does have a dew claw up in here too. Getting around the dew claw so I can trim the nail, but also when I'm using the clippers, it's good to know where that is. All right, so I'm gonna trim these nails, which is very thick. You gotta give it a little bit of extra with the hand there. There, so we got one done. Right, up to the next one, buddy. Raise the table so you can see. Eventually, I hope he'll lay down, but just when I'm doing the feet here, but some like to stand or sit. Just gotta get in there. There you go. Good boy. With any dog, usually the feet and the face are the hardest part to do. Because they're the most time consuming and they're the most attention to detail, because you really got to get in there. And of course the dog's face and feet are the most sensitive for you to be working around, so they may be a little bit more squirmy as well. So there are lots of times I see the dog come in where their owner had groomed them, but they kind of just did the body, and then once they got to the feet or face, they kind of couldn't do it. But it just takes time and practice. And once your comfort level is better, your dog will respond too. But a lot of patience. Okay, here's these ones. Alright, there's no dew claw on the back pad. Alright, so now we're going to do the other side. Okay. Ready? Let's swap them around. There you go. Good boy. These feet are really full of hair. A little bit of mats in there as well. Probably was a little slippery for him if he was walking on any laminate or tiles. So this will give him some, a little bit more grip once his pads are exposed. Okay. Okay. Where you going? Hey. I know I get a little tired or impatient with me, but the key is to keep on going and not to stop what you're doing. Only take breaks when you want to take breaks, not when the dog initiates it, because that just reinforces his behavior. All right. Okay, so now one more paw, thankfully, left. Let me see a little bit of what is there. Oh, and one of the nails is bleeding, so I'm just gonna put some stick powder. Use the last one. There we go. And that's what I use. Just dab it on. Put it on the nail with pressure, so you put the nail into that and hold it in there so it really gets a good grip on there. And let it clot it up. So you make sure you put the compressor in there. Just hold it for a few seconds. Make sure it has good contact with all the nail. And this quick as that was that I just did, that's how long it takes. It doesn't take long, and then that will clot it up and stop it from bleeding. It's okay. Getting done. Just gotta be careful of that tongue too. Put a cone on him because I don't want his tongue coming. close to the scissors. I'm not worried about him biting me, but I am worried about those scissors getting too close to his tongue. So we're just gonna put this on. Sorry, buddy. I don't want your tongue getting cut. All right, so hopefully we can get done this last paw. Okay, I didn't do anything that time, buddy. Of course, the last paw. Okay. Must be a little bit more tender, because he doesn't like me even putting my finger in there, so. It is a little bit more sore than the other ones for some reason. Hey, let's try to get... Hey, it's okay. Just trying to pull up the fur so we'll be able to cut it. A little more sensitive on this foot. Okay. And I'll turn you here so you can see what I'm doing, hopefully. The last one, eh? Well, at least it was the last one and not all of them. If you're just starting out grooming, you'll notice your hands will get a good workout. Although you wouldn't think it's hard to hold a paw in place, you do use a lot of muscles that you're not used to using. Even after 16 years of grooming, every once in a while you get a dog that, you know, just a little bit resistant. And he's got some strength too, so. Okay, there we go. Let's use the clippers. And then you'll be ready for your bath. Really thick nails. Oh, and the new glove there. You can feel it. I'm just going to trim around the dew claw a little bit as well. Tucked in there. Okay. Ready for the baths, so we're gonna move them to that area. A little bit. There you go. Okay. There he is. So I'm going to make sure I do a good job of cleaning out that sebaceous gland area. Even just getting it wet will help me to get around it. Hey, hey, not a big fan of getting it wet there. Okay. Okay. Thank you. the fuzz that comes off him. Okay, come on. Oh, but they, whew, we're both going to get a shower today. That's okay. And as you can see, my tables and tub don't have any grip on them. It helps so I can maneuver the dog where I need them to go. Otherwise, they would be jumping out of where I needed them. There we go. Okay. Okay, so here's the sebaceous gland. And it's really red around it. I guess you can't see nothing. So there it is there. So, and then once exposed, all that is the dried blood. It'll keep oozing, so, and bleeding. So that's just the nature of the beast, I guess. So that's just to keep it clean. And you can keep wiping them. I usually do put a little styptic powder on them. That helps the bleeding for a little bit. That's a good boy. Move the shampoo a little bit. There we go. Shampoo. So I really want to give him a good, he's got really thick fur, so I really want to make sure I get him good and clean. So I'm going to add, make another batch of shampoo. Okay. So I use a highly concentrated shampoo. It's a mix of 50 to 1. Okay. And I actually just use old mustard bottles from way back when that plastic was a little softer. And then I just actually put on ketchup lids onto that. And then I mixed it all together there. That's what I use. I've been using these same bottles, I think, for like 15 years. So they have stayed the test of time. There we go. Just need a little bit more for his licks. Undercarriage. There we go. Alright, good boy. You made it. Made it through. So we made it here again. Thank you. turn when their fur is a little bit thicker, I'll just kind of turn on the intensity of the tap. Make sure I get really down in there. And I want to make sure I get all that soap out. But I don't want to use that on the head and face. There you go. Just making sure there's no soap coming out. You really want to make sure you get that all out. Otherwise the dog could be quite itchy if there's any soap residue left. There we go. Wring them out, and then I also make sure while I'm doing this process that there is no soap coming out when I do that, which there is not. That just helps take out a little bit of that water. All right. Now we're ready to go to the table. No shake?
No.
Okay. Get more dry. Gonna pause. Okay. Sorry about that. Just a delivery. We are back at it. Okay, so we're gonna give him a little blow dry. Getting them too dry because I am going to be giving them that number 10 cut, so we'll be shaving it all off. All right, we got the number 10 ready to go. I'm going to be careful of that sebaceous gland there. Nice and close around there. So the owner can keep an eye on it. There you go. I'm just going to use the scissors to get it nice and clean. Thank you. Okay, we'll keep on going. Best view here. As I said, he's a little bit bigger, so it's a little bit harder to get him in there. But as you can see, he's doing really good. Just over 31 pounds. See, there's a few warts on him. You just gotta be careful when you go around them. But usually they will bleed once they get touched with the clippers. Just want to make sure those clippers stay nice and cool. Get a little tired. stand here. Good boy. Come on up. There you go. Closer. As you can probably hear from the cookers. So it really helps that things are a little bit damp here so my cookers don't get warm or hot. Stand. Coming up. Yeah, boy. A little hard to get in that armpit when he's laying. Thank you. Okay, I'm just gonna switch here. Switch it out. It's just starting to get warm. Since he's sitting here, I'm just going to do his ears. Trim them up. Always use your thumb as a guide when you're trimming close around the ears. You want to make sure you're not catching any of that skin. There you go. Okay. So now I'm just going to trim around the thumb area. Thank you. camera's getting tired. I'll get there. Maybe. There we go. Let's lower that a little bit. There we go. I'm just going to add some oil. You just gotta work with what they'll give you. If you're a little bit tired, you just kinda gotta give them a break as they need it. Okay, so I am gonna give them another blow dry here. Just gonna take them off the table so I can clean the table. We'll just take off a little bit, but it'll clean up everything for him. Okay. Thank you. be doing a little check over. And of course, you're never going to get everything perfect on this, guys. But you got to try. There you go. Okay, so that is our boy. So hopefully you enjoyed his grooming. Like I said, you can check out my channel, and there are lots more dogs that I have groomed. And I appreciate it if you would subscribe to my channel. But I do appreciate you taking the time to watch. And please feel free to comment. It also helps once the dog's paws are wet here, and I've already done it once, it just kind of loosens up any hair that's kind of in there as well, so I can get that out. Let's see how this one's doing. Oh, that one's actually good. No, he doesn't seem to mind me digging in there. So it might have been just a little bit sore from the fur, it was pretty thick. I'm probably going to give him another blow dry here just to check to make sure I didn't miss anything. And then I'll put in his ear solution and brush his teeth. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for taking the time to watch, and I hope you keep watching. Have a good day.